Hi, in the previous video we've talked about the differences between dynamic array and linked list, and in this video we're gonna be implementing dynamic array in C++. So if you don't know how dynamic array kinda works, you can check the previous video on the topic. So in this video, what I aim to do is to kind of generally explain the implementation, and I'll leave a link to the GitHub repository where you can find the implementation, the code from this video, and if there are any bugs that I discover later, then they will be addressed in the GitHub repository. So let's move on and create a dedicated header file for the dynamic array. I'll call it just dynamic array. Now I'll give it just a generic name, dynamic array. So here I declared a simple class. Now it's a templated class, which means that our array, our dynamic array, this container is gonna work for any data type that the user chooses. So it's gonna work for primitives such as ints, floats, double, you know, and also for strings, you know, std strings, and whatever other classes that the user might define and stuff like that. So it's gonna have those private fields. Now the type, the pointer of a type, whatever type the user chooses, and we initialize it to zero, which basically means null or a null pointer, but I prefer zero. And this is a pointer, and it will point to the starting position of a block of memory that our dynamic array is gonna allocate. So basically this is a pointer to an array, to the beginning of an array. Then we have int max index, which basically means the size of our dynamic array right now. For example, if you've got 5 elements in an array, max index is gonna be 4. So the capacity means the maximum size of our array right now. So for example, if we have 5 elements in an array, it doesn't mean that it can only store maximum of 5. Maybe the capacity will be 10. And once we reach 10, for example, once we max out the capacity, say we wanna put an 11th element in our dynamic array, then it's gonna just allocate a new memory with bigger capacity, say 15. Since we're gonna be allocating memory on the heap, we also gotta have a destructor, which is gonna delete elements. Just so we make sure that we free the memory that we will have allocated during the execution of the program. We're gonna be allocating memory for an array, right? And so delete basically here means that it's gonna delete it as an array, which basically will invoke destructors. Once deleting, it will invoke destructors of each element of an array. Since you know the type of array may be a class which has some kind of destructor. And similarly with new, new is also gonna call or invoke constructors of type. Now let's add a function to push into our array, so to put values in our array. And first we're gonna implement the simplest case and the most efficient for dynamic array. Once again, you can check out the first episode for more information on why it's the most efficient. So here we check if we've maxed out the capacity of our dynamic array, and since our dynamic array has, and in the beginning, since the capacity is going to be zero, it's going to be maxed out. If it is maxed out, then we have to reallocate memory and allocate enough memory to store all the elements we already have in an array, and enough memory to put the new value that we want to add in the array as well. Here we increment max index, obviously, and then we put in the max index a value. So now let's implement reallocate function. It's gonna be private, because the user is not gonna deal with allocation, memory allocation. That's why we're implementing the dynamic array, right? Here it is. Now we create an array, and the size of array is gonna be capacity multiplied by 2 plus 1. Now we could just simply allocate enough memory for capacity plus one for just the new element, but we're gonna allocate more just to minimize the amount of heap allocations, because allocating memory on the heap takes time. Okay, so we want to minimize the amount of heap allocations, but also we then copy all the contents from the old memory region to the new memory region, so it's also not very efficient in that sense. So we want to minimize the amount of reallocations, actually, so we're gonna allocate more than we need, and more specifically, we're gonna allocate capacity multiplied by 2 plus 1. So if our capacity, for example, is 5, then when the next time we reallocate for bigger memory block, we're gonna allocate actually 5 multiplied by 2 is 10 plus 1 11. So we're gonna allocate enough memory not for 6 elements but for 11. And also, of course, our dynamic array is going to be able to remove elements from the array, but we're not gonna reallocate then, just because we can just shift all the elements, and just to minimize heap allocations once again. So we allocate this, and we're not gonna check whether or not the heap allocation was successful, because sometimes we can run out of memory, available memory to us. The heap allocation is gonna fail, but it's gonna throw a bad alloc, I think, exception. So we're not gonna check for that, we're not gonna catch it, because the user program will have to deal with bad allocation exception. Then we update the capacity field with the new capacity value. Then we copy the elements from our old memory block to the new memory block. Then we delete the old memory block. We free the memory we previously allocated, and then we just set elements field to the new block, to point to the new block of memory. It's quite a simple function, but it's one of the biggest deals, I guess, of dynamic array. That's what all the fuss is about. Dynamic array, simply the allocation, or dynamic allocation of memory. So next function is push. Most of the time, the time it takes to push back is constant, unless we have to reallocate, right? But with this pushing in the middle of an array, of a dynamic array, or in the beginning, is gonna take longer, and it's not constant. But first, let's address this line here, throw invalid index exception. Now it's an exception that we're gonna create next. Basically, if the user provides index of like 500, but our array is only, the size of our array is just 10, there's obviously, we cannot push to the index 100 because it just doesn't exist. So we say that if index is more than maximum that we currently have, then we throw invalid index exception. Here we check if we need to once again reallocate, just as we did in the pushback function. And here we have to shift all the elements that go after the index one position. So that's what we basically are doing here. We put elements at position equals to element at the previous position, and then we put the value at the index. Now let's implement the exception. For that we'll need to include exception. That's how you create a custom exception in C++. Invalid index inherits publicly inherits std exception, and virtual, so we override what, which is, and here is the message of our exception: object of that index doesn't exist. Which I don't know why I wrote this, actually. We should have written, let's leave it like that. So let's now implement the get function. So the get function takes as a parameter index, and then it returns a value of type. And if the index is valid, then we just return the value. If not, we throw an invalid index exception. We'll also need a remove function, right? So we check if index is valid. If not, we throw an exception. If it is, then we basically, and so here we will just shrink kind of our array starting from the index. So index gets, so the value at position index gets lost. And finally, we implement a size function to just to query the current size of our dynamic array. And we just return max index plus one, which is the size, the current size. And yes, and as I've already said, there will be a link to the GitHub repo in the description where you can see this code. Let's make a simple testing program. Here I made a simple program that basically pushes back the elements we input via console until we input a string with 8 in the beginning. Then it's gonna push at the index 3, push at the index 5, then it's gonna remove a bunch of times, and it's all it always is gonna be printing out. So let's see how that works. Okay. Top index, max index, not top index, and what else? Yeah, max index. Okay. Okay. Hey. Hello. So it printed the content of our array. Hello. Here it got hey, hello, world. So it seems to be pushing back fine. Let's push 8 to stop. So here we pushed 6 elements. Then we push at the index 3, 77, a string 77, an std string. So 0, 1, 2, 3, so at index 377, the rest got shifted, the rest of the elements to accommodate the 77 at the index 3, at the index 5, 120, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, at the index 5, 120, and yeah, seems to be working fine. Remove 2, so 0, 1, 2, so world gets removed, yes. Then at 5, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so this W45 gets removed, yes. And then remove 1, so hello gets removed. Seems to be working. Also size seems to be working, right? Of course, I'm gonna go through it with a debugger to test it more. Oh, and also let's try to access an element that is with invalid index. Yeah, invalid index, unhandled exception. So here we go, we've implemented the dynamic array. The third part, the next part, is gonna be about implementing linked list. And if you haven't seen the first part of this series, check it out as well. Bye.